Member for Burnaby, Deer Lake.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, the minister seems to be suggesting that there's absolutely no change for adult education. The reality is Vancouver School Board closed the Downtown East Education Center, closed the Hastings Education Center, closed the literacy outreach programs, closed programs all across this province. Thousands of students not getting the adult education that they'd be able to get. This government has put up barriers that are impossible to break down in this province for adult education learners.
Good jobs plan.
With regards to adult basic education, the minister may want to talk to a former Attorney General of his government, Jeff Plante. Mr. Plante has just been appointed to the highly regarded position of Chancellor of MLA Kathy Corrigan. In 2007, it was his recommendation that all fees for adult education be eliminated. And he said, and I quote, "The public interest in eliminating barriers to participation in post-secondary education requires that no tuition be charged to any adult learning seeking to upgrade their education," end of quote. So will the Minister of Education join with the Chancellor of MLA Kathy Corrigan, with school districts all across this province, including Kootenay, Columbia, Trail, Soup, with the Mayor of New West, and with hundreds, literally hundreds, of groups, individuals, educators who are opposed to these cuts, and will he reinstate permanent long-term funding for adult basic education in British Columbia?
Minister of Education.
Honourable Speaker, as I said earlier, on this side of the House, we want to encourage and we want to promote the fact that we understand the stability that's required for adult education in the province. And that's why, as I mentioned, Honourable Speaker, that we've ensured that anybody who wants to go and get their Dogwood diploma can do so free of charge in the province of British Columbia, thanks to the government on this side of the House.
Burnaby Deer Lake on a supplemental.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Well, surely the minister will know that that free education is not available at the post-secondary level. VCC's enrollment, the largest provider of adult basic education in this province, their enrollment is down 30% to 40%. Thousands of students who have had a barrier put in their way. Obviously, Mr. Plante's views are held in high regard by this government if he's just been appointed to the position of Chancellor of MLA Kathy Corrigan. His recommendations resulted in this government providing upgrading courses for graduated adults free of charge back in 2008. What this government labeled, and I quote, the education guarantee. Now the government has turned their backs on this guarantee and canceled funding for upgrading courses for adults who have graduated. And so again to the minister, will he finally reverse these short-sighted cuts that are hurting adults and are slamming the door to education for adult learners in this province?
Minister of Education.
So, Honourable Speaker, on this side of the House, we're really proud of the investments we've made in the education system. The reason why we're able to make those investments, Honourable Speaker, is because we vote in favour of LNG. We vote in favour of jobs. We voted in favour of Site C. Those major projects bring jobs into the programs here in the province of BC. What's also really important, Honourable Speaker, to stress, in the province of British Columbia.
Members will come to order.
85% British Columbia workers, 380 people.
Members, it's your time.
85%. 85%.
Please take your seat. We'll wait. Continue.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. I'll just finish off by saying we understand the investment's important. And over the next 3 years in the province of British Columbia, $421 million is going to be added to the education system in the province of British Columbia, something this side of the House is proud of because of the opportunities in British Columbia.